Today, I've got a super cool trick to share that's going to make your motion tracking way more accurate and hassle-free. We are going to use a high-pass filter and turn it into an animation preset. How awesome is that? Now, one of the questions I get from my students is, Eran, how do I make my motion tracking better and easier? Well, I actually have a whole series on that, link is down below, but today I'm giving you one of my special favorite techniques, actually a recipe, that will work wonders no matter what software you are using. Now, if you're new here, hi, my name is Eran Stern, your friendly neighborhood motion designer educator with over 30 years of experience helping designers level up their skills and smooth out the rough spots in After Effects. One of them is motion tracking. So there are plenty of ways to track footage, and with modern tools like the Camera Tracker and Mocha AE, the process is more automated. However, no matter what tools you are using, your result will always depend heavily on the quality of the video that you are working with. Let me show you exactly what I mean. So I got this drone shot from my friend Yishai Shapir. This was shot, I think, in Long Island. It doesn't really matter. I'm just going to escape out of full screen, go to the beginning, select it, and under animation, I'll apply the track camera effect, which is actually the 3D camera tracker. After Effects will start analyzing it in the background, and after a few moments, we'll have this result. I'll move the CTI, and we'll see many colorful trackers. It all looks fine until we'll open up the advanced options and have a look at the average error. In this case, it's higher than 1 pixel, so 1.19 to be exact. And this means that whatever I'm going to add to this scene will have an accuracy of above 1 pixel. Now, for closer element, it's not a big deal, but for something in the background, you may be able to see the shift. So we need to find a way to reduce the average error and improve the accuracy of the track. And this is where high-pass filter comes into play. In case you don't know, a high-pass filter is a signal processing technique that allows high-frequency components of a signal to pass through while reducing the low-frequency components. In the context of visual effects and motion design, especially in programs like After Effects, high-pass filters are used to enhance details, sharpness, or edges by isolating high-frequency textures in an image. However, as things stand now, there isn't any built-in plugin that can do it. Well, this is not exactly correct. There is a name-your-own-price plugin that you can find from aescript.com. The link is down below. I want to quickly show you how to work with it and what is the issue that I have with it and why we're actually going to do it ourselves. First, I'll remove the 3D camera tracker from this shot. I'll head over to the effects and presets. I already installed the High Pass for AE plugin. I'll double click on it. And as you can see, this is the result that we are getting. We can try to improve it by playing with the radius in pixels. It's not exactly giving us what we want in order to improve the tracking. And there is also another gotcha here, this warning icon. I'll click on it to show you that this effect may slow down preview and export because it is not optimized for multi-frame rendering. So let's create our own as well as save it as an animation preset. I'll remove this and I'm going to start applying a few effects. So I'll start by typing in fast to get access to the Fastbox Blur. I'll set the radius to 2 and the iteration to 6. So right now I'm just giving you the recipe, but obviously you can change those numbers and I'll show you what they are doing. All right, I'm going to continue applying effects from the FX console over here. So let's add the invert effect. I'll leave it as is, and then I'll apply the CC composite effect. In this case, I'll change the opacity to 50%, making sure I'm not touching anything else. And already we are more or less in the same area that we just saw a moment ago using the Name Your Own Price plugin. However, to make it work with camera tracking and other stuff, because this is great if you just want to enhance details, you can actually duplicate the footage. Let me show you what I mean. And I'll remove everything from this copy, then return to the upper one, which has the high pass filter. And then I can switch the blending mode to overlay. And this is basically going to create a sharpening version of this. So almost like an unsharp mask, but a little bit more clever with more controls. But this is not what we are after. I'll delete the other copy, re-enable the effect. What we want is to create a version with more details so the camera tracker and other trackers in After Effects are going to use it and get us better results. So on top of everything over here, I'll apply the levels effect and I'll take the input black, drag it to the beginning of the histogram. I'll do the same thing with the input white, and this will create a better input for the camera tracker effect. Now, in order to use it, we'll need to pre-compose this shot. So I'll press Command Shift C and I'll rename this Jetty HP. No relations to Hewlett Packard, but high pass, of course. Move all the attributes into the new composition and click OK. And now I'll reapply the track camera effect. And while it's working, I'll open up the advanced option so we can immediately see the average error. So we went from 1.2 almost to 0.58, which is 2 times better, meaning the tracking here is going to be much more accurate. Now, in order to work with this footage again, we'll need to double click on this comp, disable all the effects, and then of course, we can return back to the camera tracker and maybe just click somewhere over here, create a text and a camera. I'm going to double click on this text and name it Jetty. And then I'll select it over here and I'll change the X rotation to 90 degrees as well as scale this text down. It doesn't need to be so big. It's just to show you that this is going to be much more accurate. I'll pause it over here, reselect the effect, and then I'll create another object over here. So maybe another text. Again, I'll just scale it up. We can just leave it as is because what we want to check is just the accuracy of the solve. And as you can see, we have a much better result. If you want to take it further, I'm just going to double click on the final comp that I've created previously. Over here, I've imported a 3D model of a mermaid that I found over at sketchfab.com. I've linked it down below if you want to give it a try. And if I'll preview this comp, you can see how everything is working together. So this is going to give you much more accurate results. Now, to make our life more simpler, we can head back to the comp with all of the effects over here. I'll re-enable them so you can see them. And then I can select everything. Go under animation and select save animation preset. And of course, there is a link to download it. If you just want to use my preset, just note you'll need After Effects 2024 or higher. And also make sure to play with the levels adjustment because every footage is going to be different. Here are 2 more examples. One of them is this shot. And as you can see, we have some element that I've placed in the background, in this case, a flying dragon. And the results I got using this high pass technique are much more accurate. Another example is this comp. And this is a little bit more complicated. I've actually used Mocha AE to track several things over here. So let me know in the comments below if you want me to create a step-by-step tutorial and show you everything I did here because there are a few challenges except of course, improving the tracking result using the high pass filter. If you want to learn more about motion tracking in After Effects, make sure to check this playlist. There's also a link down below. Until then, thank you so much for watching and I hope this technique is going to help you with your work.